All right, hey everybody, Rob Maurer here, and today we are going to go through Tesla's Q4 2020 delivery and production report. So I'm just going to wait a second here and make sure everyone can hear me, make sure the audio is good, and then we'll jump into the report. How you guys doing this morning? It's an early one for me. Woke up and saw the report. Tesla surprised us a little bit with the Saturday report. This is the first time in their history they've reported a Saturday delivery and production number report. All right, so just waiting here for some responses, and then we will get started. All right, people are saying hi, Rob, in the comments, so I'm like assuming that means everything's working here. Audio is great. Awesome. We will get started then. So I've got the delivery and production report pulled up here. Let me just switch over to that on my window. So, all right, so it's Tesla was so close. They were so close to hitting 500,000 vehicles delivered for the year. They have reported, we'll just skip right to the bottom here, total deliveries 2020, 499,550. So they were just 450 vehicles short of hitting their original guidance of 500,000 vehicles produced and delivered. Of course, on the production line, they easily exceeded that. Total year came in at 509,737 vehicles produced. So where Tesla fell short, they needed to deliver 181,020 vehicles. They delivered 180,570 vehicles. That was 18,920 Model S and X, 161,650 Model 3 and Model Y combined. If we look at production there, we can see Model S and X relatively low, but again, we did have that final week of the quarter shut down for retooling, possibly refresh. So they produced just over 16,000 Model S and X in the quarter, well below their production capacity of, 90,000 per quarter is what they've stated, which would be 22,500 per quarter. And then for Model 3 and Y, they produced just over 163,000, 163,660. So total quarterly production was 179,757, with the deliveries again being just over 180,000. The last thing I'll note on this portion of the report is that Tesla does say, I'm not sure if you guys will be able to see it here, but our delivery count should be viewed as slightly conservative, as we only count a car as delivered if it is transferred to the customer and all paperwork is correct. Final numbers could vary by up to 0.5% or more. So this is something we usually talk about when we have our earnings preview, but Tesla actually usually adds a couple hundred vehicles at the end when they actually finally report their final numbers. Because of that reason there. So I do actually think they're going to add a few hundred here, and I think they're going to be even more excruciatingly close to hitting 500,000 for the year. I bet they come in at like 499,850 or something like that. So, they say in the report we produced and delivered 500,000 vehicles. I think they're so close, if we round at all, we get them there. So congratulations to Tesla for achieving that. Incredible results given the pandemic that's been going on this year, the production shutdowns they've faced. Certainly if they had not faced those shutdowns, they would have been able to achieve deliveries they had 7 weeks shutdown at Fremont. This is a couple of, that's probably 15,000 vehicles or so that they weren't able to produce during that shutdown. They had a couple weeks at Shanghai as well. So I would have guessed if, that hadn't happened, they probably wouldn't have been able to deliver somewhere around 525,000 for the year. Really happy with that. Let's flip over here to Excel. And we can just take a look at this. Obviously, I did my projections last night. So we'll just compare to how the numbers came in versus those projections. So let me pull that sheet up here. So some of you may not even have even had a chance to watch the projection episode yet, but even though my numbers are a bit off, I would definitely still recommend that just because it kind of gives us some context for what's going on in terms of how the actual numbers came in. So let me again flip over to Excel. You can take a look here. So I have Q4, the actual numbers here, at least in terms of what we've got so far. We obviously don't have the split between Shanghai and Fremont yet because we're still waiting on the reports out of China on Shanghai production. While we're on that topic though, some of you would ask why Fremont doesn't report monthly production. It's not actually Tesla doing this reporting unless it's something that's required by the Chinese government. So I'm not exactly sure how they're getting these numbers, but they have seemed to be pretty close for us in the past. So I have decided to start trusting those. Those are, again, these numbers in orange. But it's not something that Tesla does by choice. If they are reporting it, it's something that's required. And if not, it's just something that's, you know, being reported out of China that Tesla isn't officially giving themselves. So that's the reason for that discrepancy. But anyway, we can see here that total production came in at, again, just under 180,000. So I was about 3,500 units too high. Actually, I feel pretty good about that production forecast. And actually, the main difference here was in Model S and Model X production. So if we hop over here to sort of the Fremont breakdown, you can see that I had estimated about 18,000 Model S and X produced, again, based on that capacity of 22,500. We actually came in at, you know, just over 16,000. So of the 3,500 vehicle miss here, you know, 3,800 vehicle that I was over by, about 2,000 of that, so a little over half of that, was actually just from S and X. And then obviously for 3 and Y, that would be the balance. We don't really know exactly how that broke down. So in this case, I just have that as going into the Model Y. So I've dropped my estimate there down from 40,000 to about 38,500. So again, that puts the total year at 509,700 produced. So really good results there. That's just under 10,000 per week for the entire year, even including those weeks that we had shut down. So if we just talk about actual production weeks, Tesla definitely averaged over that 10,000 mark for the year, which is pretty cool. I'm just trying to think if there's anything else here I want to mention on the production line. We'll take a look at deliveries here, and then we'll hop over into some chats. So let me get this pulled up. We can zoom in a bit here. Bear with me. So this is over to the delivery number again. So if you saw the projection episode, this is exactly what we walked through in that episode. So I was, again, forecasting deliveries of about 186 or 187,000. So something got changed there, but you can go back to the actual episode and see that. But if we look at the actuals here, so actual deliveries came in at 180,570. Again, we can calculate Tesla's days of inventory from that number. We just divide it by 75. That gives us what 1 day of supply would be. And then, you know, we just divide their remaining inventory by that number to figure out what we've got left. So sort of confusing there, but it looks like Tesla has about 10 days of inventory left, which should be about 25,245 cars. So I'd actually estimated that coming down. It's because I changed my production number here. So that's just going off that smaller number. But I'd estimated that inventory would actually be reduced by about 4,000 vehicles. And it looks like we actually only ended up having it reduced by, you know, 700 or 800 there. So that's really where the delivery number was off by, probably half production and then half from the difference in inventory. They just didn't work that down quite as much as they did last year, for example. So last year, if we look at Q3, they started off Q4, so ending Q3, with 23,000 vehicles in inventory. They drained that down by about 8,000. To just under 15,000 vehicles. This year we started off with 26,000, so I thought, okay, they're probably not gonna, you know, drain it as much as they did last year, but they'll probably do maybe like 4,000, half of what they did last year. Turns out that was an overestimate. So this actually means, you know, even though they only have 10 days of inventory, they actually still have, you know, pretty close to the highest levels of inventory that we've seen over the last few quarters. You know, Q3 was a little bit higher. Q1 was obviously quite a bit higher with everything happening with the coronavirus situation at that point in time, right at quarter end there. So this actually puts them in a pretty good spot, a pretty healthy spot for Q1, which is exciting, assuming Tesla has that demand to carry through. So obviously they'll have to deal with the shutdown of the S and X a little bit into Q1, but otherwise it looks like things are, you know, in a really good spot. Tesla also noted in the delivery report that they have started production of the Model Y in Shanghai, and I'll begin deliveries this quarter or this month, which we talked about also in that projection episode briefly. So I think that's most of what I wanted to say from the report. You know, a little bit lower than what I had expected, obviously, but half of that coming from Model S production, Model S and X production, even though deliveries outpaced there, obviously, as they worked that inventory down, and then half of it just coming from the inventory on Model 3 and Model Y. So again, this number should come slightly up. I still think Tesla will probably miss it just by a hair, but congratulations for, you know, an amazing year and an amazing quarter. If we think about this sequentially, you know, Tesla delivered, I think, 137,000 vehicles last quarter. So to increase that by 43,000 vehicles in one quarter is really incredible progress. And this would set Tesla up at already a run rate of, you know, above 600,000 for next year by quite a bit. So almost probably 700,000. See if I can do that math here on the spot. Yeah, 720,000 if they could just continue delivering at the 180,000 per quarter level. And then in terms of production, right around there as well. All right, so pardon that. I'm just going to take a quick look here at questions. I do have to run in probably 5 or 10 minutes. I didn't really expect this release on Saturday. As we talked about, I thought it would be coming on Sunday. So let me just take a look here and see if we've got any super chats here. Thank you, Vero, for that one. I love you guys too. Again, bear with me. I'm just scrolling through the chats here. Thank you, Frank. I mean, how are you guys feeling about the report? I mean, I think this is probably a little bit lower than what we had expected, but again, you know, Tesla getting really close to that 500,000 goal. I'm sure that's eating away at them. I did my best helping out with that with my one delivery. I do have a thought here though. One of the things that we've seen Tesla do is they've added the, you know, free supercharging incentives. We saw a few days ago they added a full self-driving free trial for 3 months. With, I believe that starts in mid-January, which is kind of interesting that they chose to start that mid-January versus just on the 1st of January. So we'll see if that has any hidden meaning later on. But, you know, when Tesla offers those end of quarter incentives, I think the bearish take on that is, okay, they don't have enough demand. They're trying to get more demand so they can, you know, make their quarterly numbers. I think that's probably part of it. We've talked about that. Demand is not this fixed concept. It varies by region, it varies by product. So on S and X, you know, Tesla was probably demand constrained, at least for S, maybe not for X, but for Model 3 and Model Y, maybe not. But at the end of the quarter, when they're just producing vehicles and they're trying to find the closest customer, yeah, they might have a reason to stoke demand a little bit right by the factory so they can get that delivered within the same quarter versus having it to send it to someone that, you know, maybe has been waiting 4 or 5 months over in Europe. So there's a regionalization factor to demand that is underappreciated. But even more than that, customers have to actually take delivery of their cars for Tesla to count it, as they say there. So if you're sitting there at the end of the quarter and you're busy with holiday stuff and you don't really care if you get your car on December 28th or January 2nd, you know, there's no incentive for you to try to meet Tesla's schedule and trying to help them out with quarterly deliveries. So Tesla at the end of the quarter can add these little, you know, nice to have things like a year of free supercharging, full self-driving demo, and that will incentivize customers to actually want to take delivery before the end of the quarter. So then they're sort of aligning incentives with Tesla and with the customer. So I think that's probably actually more of a factor when Tesla's offering these things at the end of the quarter than trying to, you know, stoke demand. Although I do think that's part of it, again, the regionalization, but going through the delivery process myself and having to deal with like traveling and just holiday stuff here at the end of the quarter, for me, it probably would have been easier to just take it, you know, right after the new year than try to squeeze it in right before. But again, those incentives kind of help with that for customers. So sorry, kind of a sidetrack on that, but I just something I've been thinking about that wanted to share. And I think, you know, Tesla may have been able to deliver more vehicles and maybe they thought they would, but maybe they just didn't have the customers there with the holidays to take delivery of all the cars that they thought they would. All right, so I think I'm through most of the chat there at the bottom. Let me get back to the actual live stuff here. We got a super chat from our favorite Reddit mod over here. No offense to the other Reddit mods. I love all you guys, but yeah, 110110 has been running the show over at r/Tesla Motors for a long time, and they're getting really close to 1 million subscribers, which is awesome. So thank you to you as well. think I missed one super chat in here. Again, bear with me, and then we'll just kind of wrap up here. So good question here. Will the stock fall because of coming short? So I said, you know, I think in the projection episode, I said, I think the expectation is pretty much for Tesla to hit that 500,000 delivery number. And I think if they don't hit that, you know, there might be a little bit of a short-term reaction towards the negative. Tesla coming in right on that number, I think, is probably right aligned with expectations. So I think the market is going to instead default to the other news that we've had this week, which is, of course, the Model Y rollout in Shanghai. You know, it looks like they've already produced a few hundred vehicles there. Looks like they're already targeting production starting for, or sorry, deliveries starting for this month. And the big news is that they really, really reduced the prices of the Model Y. So, you know, 25-30% or so from what they were previously, which, you know, we've talked about, we've kind of seen coming, but that I think will excite the market more than, you know, coming up 450 vehicles short on this delivery number, which again, that'll even come up even closer. So I think pretty much right in line with expectations. I think we kind of just go on from here. People are going to start putting this into their models now. All the analysts will update their models, of course, over the weekend. And then I'm sure on Monday, we'll probably see some revised price targets and things like that, maybe even before then. So I don't expect a negative reaction. You know, who knows? Stock market on a daily basis can do whatever. But I think this is pretty much right in line with what people would have expected. And I think that Model Y news has probably surprised some people to the positive. And obviously, we carried a lot of momentum out of last week. So I would kind of expect that to continue. Thank you, Magnus. Yes, I did take delivery. So there is a video from 2 or 3 days ago, just kind of walking through that. And again, we'll go through more detail. I'm not going to switch over to being like a, you know, a Tesla car YouTuber where I'm just talking about my car all the time. But yeah, I had a video on that, and we'll continue to do some more of that. But yeah, it's been awesome so far. I love it. Driving it more today. All right, guys. Well, I do have to get running. But again, thank you and congratulations to Tesla for an amazing year in 2020. You know, I tweeted the other day, the stock started at like $83 post split at the end of last year. And now we closed at 700. It was up 734% over the course of the year. So just really from a fundamentals perspective, an amazing year. From the stock perspective, an amazing year. And I think 2021, you know, it's probably not going to have a 730% gain again, but there's so much waiting in the wings here with Model Y coming online in Shanghai, Giga Berlin, Giga Texas, Tesla continuing to, you know, refine their current products with the Model 3 refresh. Looks like we're going to see a Model S and X refresh here to some extent too. We'll have Plaid mode, the Plaid Model S coming in later in 2021, maybe earlier. We'll see on that. But yeah, a lot of exciting stuff, obviously Cybertruck. So we didn't really see new products in 2020. We had obviously the Shanghai stuff happening, but 2021, we should get back on track with hopefully some new products and definitely a lot of updates with Tesla's new factory. So a lot to look forward to. But yeah, that'll wrap it up for today. As always, thanks for listening. And I will see you on Monday, which I believe will be the January 4th episode. All right. Thanks, guys.